Calvin Cast on Route 9 in Champlain. It's the 17th day of August, 2013, and as the sign says right here, it's the town of Champlain celebrating 225 years. March 7th, 1988, the town of Champlain was incorporated by an act of New York State. In fact, this is before New York State ratified the Constitution, so forming the town of Champlain was part of forming Clinton County. And Clinton County originally encompassed Crown Point, Willsboro, Plattsburgh, and Champlain. Before that, it was part of what I believe was called Washington County, which was the Albany area. So they decided it'd be a good idea to have a local government a little closer to where they were. So they formed the town of Champlain under the insistence, we'll call it, of Pliny Moore and some of the folks in Plattsburgh. He got some of the folks in Plattsburgh to go along with him and petition the state to form a town, and they formed this town 225 years ago. So the town of Champlain is trying to do it up right, and they're doing it up right here today. It's been a busy day for Hometown Cable, myself and Judy Castine behind the camera. We've started the day at the Champlain Telephone Company open house. They're celebrating their 110th year. We then went to a Noadiah Moore historical marker dedication in front of St. Mary's Church, recognizing Noadiah Moore and his efforts for the Underground Railroad and getting slaves, escaped slaves, we should say, into Canada in safety. We then went back to the Champlain Phone Company event. Judy was there covering some things while we were gone. Then we went to the Champlain Village Fest. They're having their third annual Village Fest as part of what is normally the townwide garage sale, Champlain Phone Company open house, and Champlain Village Fest Day. Today, we have the added attraction of 225 years for the town of Champlain. The village is 140 years old this year, but the town is 225 years old. A committee got together and decided that they would get all this done. It's going to be highlighted by a free, to the public, Gibson Brothers concert. And we just said hello to Eric and Lee Gibson, and they've agreed that they will chat with us in about 45 minutes. So we're looking forward to talking with them. And they've been just nominated for 7 new country, Bluegrass Music Awards. They were the Entertainer of the Year last year. So they are really riding high. They are a group from the Ellenburg, Cherubusco area. A couple of young guys that grew up there. Gibsons grew up there and went on. And they've been doing the whole region proud, and wherever they go, they get an overflow crowd. And we're just hoping here with this free concert here that things won't get too far out of hand, because it's going to be first come, first served when it comes to seating. So we're hoping it won't be Woodstock North. One thing we haven't got to worry about is rain. God has given us a beautiful, picture-perfect day. Everywhere we went to the activities today, it's been downright beautiful. We're going to look around here and look at some of the vendors that are here, some of the people that are set up, and maybe hopefully have some of them to chat with. We're going to try to see if we can get some of the organizers to chat with us. After our 3:30 interview with the Gibsons, there'll be an official ceremony welcoming everybody, dedicating a wayside monument here somewhere, dedicating the 225th anniversary of the town. Not quite sure where that will be posted here on this Route 9 location. And then they'll be on to the Gibson Brothers. Chances are we won't be able to cover that Gibson Brothers concert, but the folks here will certainly enjoy it, and we'll enjoy visiting and staying here, and if not recording it, then at least sitting back and enjoying it. So Judy and I are going to move over, and we'll try to find somebody to talk to. Okay, first of all, in case Judy runs the camera this way, Julie Castine here is down a little bit on the hill. I'm standing on the top of the hill. Actually, we can almost see eye to eye on some things. Julie, you're the town clerk here in Champlain, and you're part of this this committee that put all this together. And you've brought some ponies along today.
Oh yes, I've got two of my little mares and their little babies, and then I've also brought my little miniature donkey with me.
Yeah, and Judy's taking a picture of one of them taking a pee. Boy, Judy,
that's a good shot.
We needed to see that, Judy. Thanks.
And then also my niece has brought her little bunnies up there, little lion head bunnies. And then the Ghoulie triplets have decided to bring their little Billy the Goat.
Billy the Goat.
And,
okay,
and we've got
your donkey?
Yeah, this is my donkey, Rambo.
All right, there's donkey, Rambo.
Uh-huh.
The Ghoulie triplets, Carter, Logan, and Emma.
Yeah, they got their little goat there, Billy the Goat.
Billy the Goat.
And then over in the last pen is Candy and Mike Thibodeau's Zeboos. They're miniature cows.
Miniature cows. Oh, we'll have to take a look at those guys.
Yeah, they come from Virginia. That's where they purchased them. But now they live in Perry Mills.
Perry's Mills.
Perry's Mills.
No, don't become one of those Perry Mills people. It's Perry's Mills. It always has been, and I don't care what they tried to do 25 years ago to change that. It's going to remain Perry's Mills. So you don't have one of the lime green. You got a lime greenish shirt, but not the official.
I do have a T-shirt, but I didn't put it on because it was so hot.
Yeah, it's a very nice day today. So.
But we've had a nice little turnout. I mean, people in and out all day. We've had Penelope the Clown here. We got Cotton Candy, the Bouncy House. We got hot dogs being sold. They've got the stamp cancellation over there. Northern Headwaters is
okay,
here.
There's a booth.
Hudson Headwaters is set up over there.
Okay. And you keep turning away from that microphone here.
Oh, right? I'm sorry. Earlier we had a dog show going on. The Lapiers from the McBride Road had their dogs.
Okay.
But it got a little too warm for the dogs.
I can understand
so
that.
They had to head out early.
Okay, well that's understandable. We're about 2 hours before the Gibson brothers start. And come on through, Emma. You can come through here.
We won't.
You have to ask her a question. All right, we're gonna cut it off just because Emma Gooley wants us to stop talking. Okay, we are rolling again, and we have relocated. And what are these little calves called?
They're called Zeboos. They're
Zeboos.
Miniature cows.
So are these full-grown Zeboos or?
No, they're just five. One's 5 months old, the other one's 5 and a half.
Okay. I think what he did was brought a couple calves and he's fooling you, Julie. I don't know if you...
No, I don't know.
So they're not going to get much. They're going to be like your miniature
ponies.
Yeah,
they're going to be about the size of our miniature ponies. Yep. I think they said the biggest they get is like 40 inches tall.
Okay. They probably don't give a lot of milk then.
No, they don't.
They probably don't eat as much hay, so that's an option.
No, they don't eat a lot.
Trade-off.
Mike said they don't eat. They're owned by Mike and Candy Thibodeau.
Okay.
And they don't eat a lot. Mike could tell you a little bit more about them.
All right. Well, maybe we can get a chance to chat with him. So that's why in the Thibodeau farm right there in downtown Perry's Mills?
Yes.
Okay. I went to school with several of the Thibodeau boys. Girls. What else should we know here? You've got a lot of things going on. A whole lot of people are wearing those lime green shirts, so you have a lot of help today, I guess.
Yes, we have. I think there was like 40 volunteers. And there was other people that didn't have the shirts on that helped out a lot, too. We've had a lot of help. People have been very good.
Okay, you're selling items. I know there's supposed to be some books for sale.
The booklets are over underneath the white tent.
Okay.
And also the Gibson brothers too have stuff for sale. Like they have their T-shirts,
and so
yes, and hats.
Hopefully there'll be a demand for that because we wanted to get them to come back for the 250th, don't we?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, because I'll still be around. I'm sure you will too.
I will. Yeah, Judy will.
Yeah.
Judy will still be behind that camera. So yeah, we'll.
Yeah, because I'll be here. I'll still be young.
Yeah, well, you'll be 50.
Yeah.
Or thereabouts.
A little bit older, I think.
In the vicinity of, give or take a decade or whatever. Okay, anything else, Julie, before we leave you? Maybe we could talk to one of the Ghoulie boys here. Let's rearrange his camera here. Excuse me here. You got a goat behind that tree?
Yes.
It's really a goat behind that tree, Judy, whether you believe it or not. I don't know if you can pick up that tripod and move it while we're talking here. What's your name?
Carter.
Carter who?
Carter Ghoulie.
Carter Ghoulie. I heard there's three of you guys.
Yes.
Are they all named Carter?
No.
No? What are the others' names?
My brother is Logan Ghoulie and my sister is Emma Ghoulie.
Oh. I think I've seen you over at our house once or twice, huh?
Yeah.
With my grandson, Abram.
Yeah.
So what's so special about this goat?
He is a pygmy goat, and he likes to eat everything.
Everything?
Yes.
He left part of an apple there. He must be full.
Yeah.
So, is this the only goat you got?
Yes.
Yeah? And where do you keep them? You keep them in your bedroom in the wintertime, or what do you do?
No, we keep them with our chickens.
With your chickens, okay. Does he get along with the chickens?
Yeah.
Does he doesn't eat eggs, does he?
No, but he eats the back of their tails.
He eats the back of their tails. Well, they're probably not so happy that he's back there with them.
No, no, they aren't.
Okay, well, anything else you need to tell us, Carter?
He is 3 years old.
He's 3 years old, and you're 11?
Yes.
All right. Okay, and you plan on having him for at least another 3 years, I hope?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, anything else?
Nope.
All right, we appreciate you talking with us.
Okay.
All right, tell your brother and sister that you got on TV and they didn't.
Okay.
All right, thanks. Okay, this person here wants it short and sweet. I just talked to a short, sweet little guy named Carter.
Aww.
You know who that is?
I do. I happen to know who he is very well.
Okay, we've got Carter's mother here. Melissa, I saw you taking pictures earlier today up at the Noadiah Moore dedication.
Yeah, a little hobby on the side.
You're a photographer?
Yeah, just for fun.
Yeah, just for fun?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, well, I want a couple 8x10 glossies.
Okay, you got it.
But you are here on official duty right now for an outfit called HHHN?
Yes, Hudson Headwaters Health Network.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now what the heck, if you're new to town, what the heck is Hudson Headwaters Health
Network? They are big health. They're a federally qualified health center. We have 16 centers. We're the most north. We have all the rest being Moriah, Ticonderoga, and more southern. You know, a very big growing network, and you know, we serve everyone, you know, in regards to ability to pay. Everyone is welcomed in, and you know, actively recruiting new providers and doctors and patients.
Okay, and right now you're
primary care
operating out of the North Country Medical Center.
North Country Medical Group's old building. Yep, yeah. They took us over. Dr. Racine is still our MD there. He's our medical director. Okay. And we currently have 4 mid-levels. We have Julie Steele Goodwin. She's a PA. We have Marilyn McClure, a nurse practitioner. Shabanu Zandi, a nurse practitioner. And Andrea Farrell, who is a nurse practitioner.
Okay, any of those new since Hudson Headwaters
took
over? Yep,
Andrea Farrell is our newest nurse practitioner, and since she's come on, we have extended our hours. Mondays, we're now open 8 to 8. Coming in second week of September, we'll also be open 8 to 8. Thursdays, we're open 8 to 8, and Wednesdays and Fridays until 6.
Okay, now, with more practitioners, you're going to need more sick people.
Well, we do have...
Or healthy people that don't want to get sick.
We already have a patient base of about 4,000 patients.
Uh-huh.
But we are always taking new patients, yes. Absolutely.
How long is the waiting list?
It's better now that we have Andrea. It generally takes about 3 to 4 weeks to get in as a new patient.
Okay, so if you got this sudden pain, you're not already a patient, don't go running.
Well, give us a call and we will see what we can do. There's always exceptions.
For emergencies or?
Well, we prefer not to have emergencies walk in.
Right,
you know, we're not an ER, we're not equipped for that.
Right,
but,
right.
You know, if somebody's really taken sick and not really needing the ER, give us a call. We'll see what we can do.
You got a number?
We do. I have some business cards here. You can take them. It's 518-298-2691.
That sounds like the same old number.
It is the same old number. Yes, absolutely.
I used to call that number at 8 o'clock at night and...
And there's
Southwick.
Absolutely.
Joanne would answer and say, what do you want?
Well, Joanne won't answer anymore. We do have somebody on call 24 hours a day, though.
Oh, you
on
do?
On the weekends, we do. Dr. Racine takes call all the time.
Okay, but if you call, you'll probably get an answering
service. You'll get an
service.
Answering service, and if the answering service feels it needs a physician, or, you know, they will direct you to him.
Okay.
Absolutely.
All right, and what is your official title?
I am the nurse manager.
Nurse manager?
Yes.
Yep. Allison,
yes, she's one of our, yes.
How do you do that?
I don't know.
I've known Allison
she's an LPN
40 years,
the center.
Right?
Yeah.
So you must be really good if you can manage people like Allison.
She's not hard to manage.
Okay.
Good crew.
Yes, we
anything
do.
Else we should be asking you that you want to... Big news.
Keep an eye on it.
Yeah, we're here to stay. Things are coming. We're only going to get bigger. Yep.
Okay.
It's a great company.
Do you expect to be able to announce anything big in the near
future? I think that there will be some announcements in the near future.
Not too distant future?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
Yep.
We won't ask you what those
no,
are.
No, I'm not allowed to say, but I think there will be some announcements in the future.
Okay. What, so what are those announcements? Oh, I forgot. I wasn't going to ask for that. Okay. Yeah. Anything else, Melissa?
I think that's all. Nope, come see us.
Yep.
All right, well, good quality medicine.
All right. So if you got a cough or not, you can still give them a call and stop in.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
All right. And maybe say hello to Mo.
A lot of new improvements.
They did make a lot of improvements and a lot of great preventative measures. It's a great organization.
Okay. So like I said, it's more than just if you're sick.
Oh, absolutely.
If you want to avoid being sick.
It's all about preventative medicine.
It's health care.
Preventative medicine. Yep.
Not sick care, it's health care.
Right, that's right. Absolutely.
You can use that if you want.
Okay. It's health care.
It's not sick care, it's health care.
Yeah, not sick care, it's health care. Got
right.
it?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, we're looking at a drawing of 225th anniversary of the founding town of Champlain, 1788 to 2013, Champlain Day Station. August 17, 2013, Champlain, New York, 12919. Are we at the Champlain Day Station?
Yes, we are.
Do you have any idea who drew that picture?
I think so. I think I know the guy pretty well. In fact, it's me. I'm the guy who did this. I do most of the artwork for the town.
Joe Grimshaw, and we have the postmaster. Even though she's a lady, the title is postmaster.
Sorry.
But if Brenda.
If there's a car there,
Munnick.
I know, but your kids are.
Vandermunnick.
That's
right.
You see a car parked next to her.
She's a Willette Munnick.
Well, that's much easier to say.
Okay.
Oh my gosh.
Have you done any of these for the town since 2009 here? 2009?
No, this is the first one since 2009.
It's a quadricentennial.
Quadricentennial was the last one. This is actually the fourth one I've done. I've done one. I did one in 1999 for rural postal carriers, and then 2006. I did one. Then 2009 was the quadricentennial, and then this year. And
what was 06?
What's that?
What was 06?
06 was, it was for Champlain. I'm not exactly sure.
Champlain Monument.
Monument.
In front of
yes,
St. Mary's.
Exactly. That's what it was. Yeah. So.
Okay, well, that monument was dedicated in 07, 1907, so.
Yep, so I think they were planning on, I'm not sure exactly.
They might have started the.
I think it was started in 06.
The quadricentennial.
Exactly. The celebration was started for that.
Quebec was doing a lot of stuff then because. Old Sam Champlain was north of the border before he came down south of the border in 1609. Brenda, what happens here?
Well, I was approached by Jane West from the town and Celine, expressing an interest in doing a special cancellation. We need about 10 weeks notice.
Okay.
And we said we wanted to have a special day station here to commemorate this event. So we started the paperwork on the Postal Service's end. We approached Joe and said we were looking for some artwork, and that's where they dug through and found this wonderful picture of Pliny Moore, who also was a postmaster in his day for the U.S. Postal Service, so I found that very interesting. But we came up with this wonderful stamp. The Postal Service creates the cancellation, which is for today. In the next 30 days, you can get this cancellation at my office in Champlain. And it's a wonderful souvenir for people that love to collect stamps. And just to say that you were here today, it's really amazing. It's a wonderful thing. And a talent like Joe, it doesn't get any better than this.
Yeah. Now, what happens to the actual stamp after?
Well, this I've donated every one that I've done, which is this is our third special cancellation since I've been postmaster in Champlain. I donate them rather than send them for destruction like the Postal Service requires. I get a special sign off that I donate them to Celine Paquette for the Champlain Museum. So they will forever be held there in addition to, you know, the commemorative pieces that she purchases, and they're on display. So she's going to have a nice setup when for Champlain for all posterity.
Okay, no, she can't use that to send out her postage a year from now, can she?
Absolutely not. She's well in control of what she can and can't do with this. So, but this is just for today only and for 30 days. So, and after that, it's done.
Okay, so people who weren't here today or watching this on the internet or should get it on cable before then, they can still have it done?
They can come to the Champlain Post Office, absolutely, and get a purchase of one of these special cancellations.
Okay, so that's till the middle of September.
Right, 30 days.
So that'd be the 30 days past September.
From today. That's right.
So that's the 16th of September.
That's right. It'll be the
16th. So, Joe, you don't just draw a picture every 3-4 years. What else do you do?
No. I actually do this for a living. I do a lot of work online now. I run my own design business, and I have a website. And
what's it called?
It's right now, it's jmg132.wix.com/JoeGrimshawDesign, all one word.
That's the website or your
that's,
email?
That's the website.
That's so easy to remember. I'm sure people must be flocking.
We're working on the official one, which is actually JoeGrimshawDesign.com, which is up. Okay. But it's, but right now, we're just that's the one that's operating. The new one will be out probably in about a month or so. So basically, I just do work, anything in graphic design, cartooning, illustration, and run the gamut of those. I do work with a number of businesses across the country, and I also do some work locally. And it keeps me pretty busy. You know, I get everything from logos to CD covers, poster design, everything in between. So anything that's visual, anything that has to do with design of any kind, they send it my way, and I send it back finished, and hopefully they're happy with it. So.
Okay. Anybody who can't remember that wonderful website name, is there a phone number?
There is a phone number, actually. It's area code 518-297-6550. And you can also reach me at my email address, which is jmg1@localnet.com. So that's the way you get in touch with me if you need something done.
But. Okay. Brenda, these are 55 cents each?
Is 55 cents each, that's right.
So that includes the price of the stamp?
That's right. And the beautiful blue parchment envelope, which I hand-selected after cataloging and looking through many designs. That's the one that went the best with our stamp. So
you can, and you can actually use this to send somebody a card
absolutely.
Or a note.
If you want to let it go and you want to pop something in the mail, you can mail it.
You might have a friend or a relative that lives cross-country.
You can send
from
them
here, you can send them that. And when they get it, they'll have the cancellation.
And a souvenir as well, yep.
All right.
No gambling.
All right. Anything else? So you guys stopped and we were walking by and they flagged us down and said, please come over and talk to us.
Yeah. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. We'll just take a look here, Judy. We won't go over and top them because they're very busy making money here. But we got Mike and Hannah and Koviak here. I'll tip the camera over here. So that Mike and Hannah are busy selling souvenir books and a whole lot of stuff here. And it's just part of the activities going on here today at the Champlain Town Complex. And we're going to try and see if we can catch Eric and Lee and find out a little bit about what's happening in the life of the Gibson brothers. They have a lot of things going on, a very successful group from the area, and we're pleased as punch with what's happening with them. Okay, I promise you we'll be talking to Eric and Lee Gibson, and they'll be here momentarily as soon as Lee gets his suit on. Is that the situation? They do his hair, yeah. He's got to polish his hair. So Eric is waiting for us here. We'll talk to him in a moment. But quickly, I want to talk to Jane West here, one of the co-conspirators here. So far, is living up to what you hoped, Jane?
Yes, absolutely. Even better, really.
Even better.
Yeah,
even
better, yeah. Okay. Great cooperation, a lot of nice friends, folks. What can I say?
Okay.
It's a big event. It's a great event, 225th anniversary of the town, and to help us celebrate with the Gibson brothers is just unbelievable. It really is, yeah.
It's an amazing event. So
yeah.
I'm hoping that things will progress as they have, and it looks like it's going
to
be
We try to think of all the possibilities of parking and security, medical.
We've got 40 people on staff, so.
Yeah, we have a few here. A lot of nice volunteers right behind me.
I'll move over here. Yeah. So Judy can see the nice volunteers.
Kathy Duquette and Donna Bowmel.
They just did it for the shirts. That's all.
That's right. Yeah.
That's the only reason they did it.
And they are selling the Gibson brothers.
Gibson, yeah. They're going to probably be following the Gibsons around the country.
Could
here.
Be.
They're auditioning for a full-time job here.
So the weather's cooperated. What else can I say? We've had good friends, good neighbors, good community. So
very well put. I won't ask you to say anything else.
Okay.
You're not going to top that, Jim.
Oh, I know. There was a lot of nice events today. I wasn't able to participate, but I hear that the Champlain Telephone Company went very well. The unveiling of the history marker, the village with their event down by the river, and then Celine's Paquette's History Center had the nice exhibits.
Yep.
So maybe sometime this week I'll get down to see them.
We even got to catch Mary McCaffrey singing with Dean Trombley's.
Oh, Mary was there? Yeah. Oh my gosh, sorry I missed that. Yeah,
so
very good.
You just watch Hometown Cable. You
okay,
catch all that stuff.
I do every chance I get, Calvin.
Okay. All right, thanks,
thank you for being here as well, and hopefully the day will only get better.
Let's hope so.
Okay.
All right, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Now, unlike your brother who was doing the mic check with shorts and a light shirt on, you're up there all dressed, ready to go.
Well, I didn't realize that there'd be all kinds of places to change, and I just came from home. I dressed at home, and cause you never know. So, seeing we live so close to here,
still in Brainerdsville. Eric?
Yep, still in Brainerdsville.
Yeah. This is I can't remember who's older.
I am by 11 months.
11 months.
Yeah,
very close. Which one of you was the star for Jim Schutt's baseball team?
I don't know if either of us was a star. We both tried real hard. We actually had some good teams back in the late 80s. My senior year and Lee's junior, we went to the States, lost by one run, and I was a losing pitcher. And it still haunts me. One run. Didn't have it that day.
I think I just missed. I got Lee in one of those games on tape that we recorded, but I think I just missed you. I wasn't doing a lot of NAC at that time because Altona and Ellenberg didn't have cable, so I wasn't doing much coverage. So once Altona got cable, then I started doing more coverage, and then obviously when Ellenberg got cable, then we did more coverage there. So I do have one with Lee, but we were just a year ahead of him. I think we missed out on you.
Yeah.
No record of your
those are fun times.
Stellar career.
You know, that's the only hobby I ever had that ever, for me, competed with music. I guess I can't call music a hobby anymore because it's what we do for a living, but I loved baseball just as much when I was a kid. I just, you know, I lived for that, you know, and I still love the sport, but there's nothing like playing it, you know, and there's such a small window to be able to do it, you know.
That's right. You know, you tell these high school kids, you're only going to get this opportunity one time.
I hear kids that'll say, well, I'm not going to play baseball this year, Mr. Gibson. I'm going to work. I say, you can work your whole life. I mean, you only have a short window if you love this sport. You know, there's nothing wrong with working either.
No.
Nothing wrong with learning how to work. But
there's some people that maybe just have to. Their family situation is such that they have to. But
I'm certainly glad that we had that part of our life, you know, baseball.
Now, you still call the North Country home. You're in Brainerd
State? Oh, yeah. I never got too far away. You know, we've traveled all over the place, but it's always good to come home. It always is.
Now, I know I saw you working there a few years back. For a while, you were helping out with Dick DeCost.
Yeah, I did that in the early 2000s. We made a record in Nashville that never came out, and we were kind of waiting for things to develop. And you know,
you were hanging around. So
I had to pay the bills. You know, so for a couple of years, Dick was good enough to bring me on, and he's very flexible. You know, he's a great guy, one of my best friends, and even as an employee, we were still friends. Sometimes that'll ruin your relationship when you go work for a friend, but he's a great guy. And
I think they're playing in Champlain tonight.
Yes, we're competing. Yeah, they are. The Busco Bandits.
If he gets a bigger crowd with the Busco Bandits at the VFW than you get.
If we don't get a big crowd here, we're going to blame him.
Everybody went to the Busco concert.
Darn it.
Now, it must have been good for a couple guys like you guys when you were growing up to have somebody like a Dick DeCost in the community, with his music oasis, and run ideas off and things.
Yeah, it was just I don't even know if we knew how lucky we were, you know. And when somebody's always there, you have I think people have a tendency to maybe take them for granted, but I don't think I do. You know, I've always respected him, and I talked to him this week for a couple hours. You know, we're good friends, and he's just a smart guy and very talented guy in many ways. You know, he can play a lot of instruments. He's a good businessman. He's a good shot. You know, he can fix. I've seen him work on cars. I've seen him do carpentry. He's one of the most talented people I've ever met. You know, and so you know, he's always been there. And you know, Gary Peacock, when he had that record store in Plattsburgh, that was another important place where we got a lot of our material. You know, go buy records and then tapes and then CDs. The years went on, and think about Dave Nichols too up in Whippleville.
The luthier.
And I have to mention Eric O'Hara from Morris, who's the guy who got us doing lessons at Dick's Country Store when I was 12 and Lee was 11. And Eric's still one of the most talented musicians I've been around, you know. And Junior Barber, you know, early on, Junior was in our band, and so there are a bunch of people. Donnie Perkins on the fiddle, you know, a lot of people locally who kind of nurtured what we were up to, you know, kind of saw some young guys coming along and you know, helped us and were nice to us, and you know, that's important. Lee and I try to be nice to young guys coming along, young people coming along now playing the music. And you know, Doug Knight was another person, you know, from Keysville, and great banjo player and great guy, and you know, we've been lucky. the North Country's been good to us. So.
Yeah, well, I can't think of a local group that has been more popular or more people boosting for than when you guys are. The whole community, when you guys have success, it's like it's the community had success, you know, the whole North Country.
Thank you.
There's more of that coming. Last year, right now you are still, because the year isn't quite over, you guys are still Entertainer of the Year.
Yeah, that's hard to believe. A year is almost up, but that was a real pleasant surprise. That wasn't something that that we really saw coming, but definitely a thrill. And you know, to get on stage at a festival or whatever event we're playing and have an MC saying Entertainer of the Year, it's still sometimes I shake my head a little bit. You know, did that really happen? But you know, if it never happens again, it happened once. So
that's right.
Right.
There won't be any steroid test to see if you were cheating or anything.
He wasn't.
Those fingers aren't natural, right?
Yeah, right.
Now I can just picture you guys. One of my favorite shows is the Andy Griffith Show, and one of my favorite parts of that was when the Darlings would show up.
Oh yeah.
And I could just picture the Gibson family in their own way. Probably nobody playing the jug, but you know, your sister Erin sings and stuff.
Yes, she
and
did.
I can
She's
just
a
picture
great
you guys
singer.
At home. Was it kind of that atmosphere where you...
Yeah, we didn't wear overalls, but...
No.
But music was a big part of our lives, you know. And we played it in church. We'd go to fiddle contests. We'd play in our living room. We'd play in my grandmother Fennelson's kitchen. I don't know if I've ever heard music sound better anywhere in my life.
Singing in the shower.
Just the way it felt. I mean, of course, you're around people you loved, but it was, it never got better than that. You know, I mean, we got better.
Yeah.
But the feeling never got better.
Yeah.
And look who's here.
Yeah.
Calvin wanted to know if you were on steroids.
Why?
Well, we might take your award away from last year.
Oh, the PEDs? Yeah. Maybe they will.
He cleans up pretty good.
He looks a lot better, doesn't he? Yeah.
I try. I work hard at it.
Well, I was just going to get into it. A couple of days ago on the internet, there comes the news. 7 awards you're nominated for this year?
I think 8.
Eight awards, seven categories.
Something like
that.
Well,
the IBMA sent a thing out with said 8. So.
8. Okay. Well,
whatever's more, that's what
we want more.
Maybe 9. Do you know off the top of your heads what these are?
There's for Album of the Year, Song of the Year, Entertainer of the Year,
again,
Vocal Group of the Year, Gospel Recorded Performance, Mandolin Player of the Year, Songwriter of the Year for Eric.
Whoa.
And then he also wrote the song that's up for Song of the Year. Yeah, he's a talented guy, isn't he?
Yeah, yeah. You must feel in awe just hanging around him.
Awe is not the right word.
Probably not.
It's not for him growing up in my shadow.
Oh, I can imagine.
Yeah, it's a big shadow.
And it gets bigger every day.
Yeah.
More Cracker Barrels we eat at, it gets bigger. Yeah.
Okay, when do you guys go down there? You're going to go down?
In September. It's end of September. We're asked to play the award show, and then we have another show in North Carolina the next day, and then they have a festival for the IBMA that weekend, so we're going back to do that. It's called Wide Open Bluegrass. We're doing that on Saturday.
Now, do you guys, even though you never expect to be nominated, you don't fill your calendar up with anything on that particular weekend?
Well, if it would fill up, we'd probably go, but we were embarrassingly available on that day.
Well, I'm glad you were available on this day.
Me too.
You guys are going to miss the RFD channel tonight at 7 o'clock.
Yeah.
You're on there.
Yep. Yeah, I know. And I'll have my wife TiVo it or whatever back home.
Sure you want to see it. And if you're not there, you'd be sitting in front. If you weren't here, you'd be sitting in front of your...
I hope I'm not wearing the same suit tonight that I wore there. That'd be embarrassing.
You do have 2, right?
Well, yeah.
Okay.
One's perpetually now. We wear your clothes in the cleaners all the time. It's unreal.
I can imagine it.
Yeah.
Do you have to live out of a suitcase very often, you guys? Or?
Yeah, we do. I mean,
certain times of the year, even at home, you're living out of the suitcase because you wind up repacking it, and you're gone in another 2 days. So you just like wash the clothes, back in they go.
And right back
my wife
has
said that. After I do my laundry and stuff, and I put it right back in. Why don't you put those in the dressers? And why? Why? Because I mean, they're going right back out on the road with me, you know. So we're gone about half the time.
Half the year.
So that's a lot of traveling.
Yep.
Have you gone overseas? Have you gone out of the U.S.?
Yeah, we played in a couple times. We've been overseas a few times. Once to Northern Ireland, and one time we flew over and did a show in Germany. And this last, in 2012, we did four or five countries. We played in Denmark, Germany, France, and Italy on a run over there. It was nice. Very beautiful place. The people, you know, they're not huge crowds, but the ones that really like bluegrass make an effort to travel pretty far in those countries to come to the show.
Well, particularly Ireland, I think the roots of bluegrass, I think, has a lot. You listen to the Irish music and stuff. I think there's a lot of the roots of that in the bluegrass sound.
I think they like that, the storytelling tradition also, you know. And don't you? Mm-hmm. Don't you think that that's pretty big over there? The story songs seem to go over well, you know.
Do you both write or just you there?
Yeah, he's a great writer.
Yeah, we both
great
write. Yeah.
So, is it, you know, constantly thinking of things? A lot of partial songs sitting in your
head? Yeah, you know, some of them sit there for years, you know. It takes a little while.
Do you have to write them down? Because a lot of times you think of something and you say, oh, that sounds good, then 2 days later you say, what?
Yeah.
One of the best things for me has been, I hated to do it. I didn't want to buy a smartphone.
Uh-huh.
But the best thing about that for me is if I get an idea, it's right there.
Yeah,
and I can just sing it into the phone and not lose a melody or an idea. And, you know, we've written ideas down on napkins, just about anything you can think of, you know.
When inspiration hits you and you want to hang on to it and don't want to lose it.
We're always writing, you know.
Yeah, well, it's part of the other people who have recorded some of your songs too, I assume. And
here and there, not so much.
After they hear you guys, can't improve on that. So why bother?
But sometimes, you know, I've tried pitching songs before to some, and they've said to me, well, why would you send this to us? You know, almost thinking like ahead of time that they're sending me their second best. They're sending me what but that's not it. You know, I mean, but
you just think that somebody else might be more in tune with them.
Or you know, if we have a time period where we've got a brand new record out and I write a new song, I might not want to wait 2 years to record that song. I might want somebody else to give it a try. And, you know, nothing's saying that if somebody else records it that we can't record it as well. And if you write it, you have a right to record it, you know.
Right. So. Yeah, obviously. All right. So you got CDs here on sale.
Oh,
T-shirts, $15. Hats are $15 and your 15 or 20. And how much are your CDs?
15.
Yeah.
And you have... How many different ones are still available at this point?
We carry the last three or four normally. We have three of them here tonight, but you can still get some of them online at Amazon.com or different places. Some of them are out of print now. But
been around long enough that we have a few out of print. So,
and if the public rises up, maybe they'll come back. Okay, well, it's getting close to 4 o'clock. I appreciate you guys taking the time.
Oh, good to see you, Calvin.
You know, it's great. And you know, everybody in the North Country follows your career, and we're glad when you guys succeed, and we're all happy.
Well, thank you. We're proud to be from the North Country.
Great to be here. Thank you.
Radio and Eric Gibson. Thank you.
The formal ceremony is about to begin, so if you want to take your seats. Is this mic okay? Well, welcome to the Town of Champlain's 225th anniversary. Will you please rise and join Mr. Jim Sorrell in the singing of the National Anthem?
Dawn's early light, what so bright?
celebration. A lot of people have worked hard to make this day possible. It is always dangerous to single out people to commend them, but there are a few who have done a gigantic job. First of all, Jane West and Julie Castine deserve thanks for being the masterminds and planners behind many of today's activities. Also thanks to Alan Racine and his highway staff for the wonderful job they have done in transforming this venue from my highway garage to a ceremonial and a concert site. Especially thank Robbie Roberts. I understand he did the flag here and the carpeting. So, also thanks to all our other volunteers, Dick Favreau overseeing the traffic and safety division, and John Cooper, I guess he was here every day helping with something wherever they needed him, and all the other councilmen and volunteers who have helped with balloons, food, sale of books, and other tasks necessary to make this day successful. And of course, our thanks to our town board for being supportive of the idea of having a celebration. A couple of housekeeping reminders. Please shut off your cell phones during the ceremony. Also, no smoking and no alcohol. You are also reminded that a historic booklet has been prepared for this occasion and is available for sale. I think they are setting up a booth here someplace. There's food and cold drinks are also available. Before the opening of the ceremony, I was informed that we were the opening act for the Gibson Brothers. There are people here this afternoon that I would like to introduce. I will introduce the speakers separately after. First of all, the members of our town board, Larry Barkham, our supervisor, Dick Favreau, our deputy supervisor, Steve Southwick, John Cooper, and Dennis Roberts, the councilman. Please give them a round of applause. Also joining them today is our code enforcement officer, Michael Tatro, our town clerk and tax collector, Julie Castine, our two judges, Jack Farrow and John LeBounty. And we have as our guest today, John Zerla, our county clerk, who's a resident of Champlain. I don't know if we have any members of the Brussels Point Board here or the Champlain Village Board. If they are here, welcome. As many of you know, the founder of our town was a man by the name of Pliny Moore. This morning, we dedicated in the village of Champlain a historic marker honoring Noadiah Moore and his wife. Noadiah was a son of Pliny and very prominent in the abolitionist movement and the Underground Railroad. We have here with us today a descendant of Pliny and Noadiah Moore. I'd like to introduce David Patrick. David for his work with the publication of the annual historic calendar documenting our northern tier history. Thank you, David. I also see our former town clerk here, Ralph Gilpin. And a former councilman, Brian Moore. There's a young man I also want to acknowledge, Joe Grimshaw. Joe is the artist selected by the U.S. Post Office to design the pictorial stamp cancellation that was available today. Thank you, Joe, for the fine work, and thanks to the Champlain Postmaster, Brenda Munnick, for her cooperation in this endeavor. We always appreciate Brenda's willingness to cooperate with all our events. Thank you. Before I started my duties here this afternoon, Larry Barkham told me to be accurate, to be brief, and to be seated. I promised him that I will be as brief as possible, no matter how long it takes. I'd like to introduce you to Larry Barkham, supervisor of the town of Champlain.
Day, a great weather day. Couldn't ask for a more perfect day. And this was all thought a couple, 3 months ago of something we could do to celebrate the 225th anniversary. It came together real well, and it made a lot of work for a lot of people. We want a special welcome to our Congressman, Bill Owens. We know it's you have a busy schedule. Thank you for taking the time out to come to this. And John, we see you everywhere. We expect you everywhere. and Harry, thank you for coming. Is Dr. Williams in your class here? She is.
How are you doing?
Okay. Also, county historian, Dr. Anastasia Pratt, thank you for coming. We wish you all well. Have a good evening. Thank everybody. Celine thanked so many people that I was going to already thank. There was many, many more major and minor parts that make this work. This worked well. We thank you all for coming. Thank you.
Thank you, Larry. Our next speaker is the Honorable Harry McManus, Clinton County Legislator representing Area 1. Mr. McManus has been a teacher at Northeastern Clinton Central School for over 40 years and is well known for his many years as the advisor to the Model UN program. He has represented Area 1 in the county legislature for 6 years.
Start by thanking the Town of Champlain Committee for inviting me to this celebration. Jane West, Julie Castine, and of course Celine have done an outstanding job of organizing and institutionalizing this celebration of our community and its local history. As a global history teacher at the high school for many years, I remember a conversation that I had with a student back in the late 70s or early 80s. Some of the NCCS students who were 18 years old would go across the border to Canada to have a drink. There may even be some of them here right now. I don't know, there's a couple of hands up. I asked this senior where he went, and he thought for a minute, and he said, I think it was called Dewey's Tavern. And as many of you know, Dewey's Tavern played a very important role in the War of 1812, and is now a private residence and located right next to the high school, so it was unlikely to happen. I know we've come a long way since then and hopefully making our young people more aware of our local history. This is a congratulatory plaque to the Town of Champlain on its 225th anniversary, sponsored by myself, Dyer, Hines, Beach, Rowden. Whereas it is the sense of the legislative body to honor and commemorate distinguished histories of the communities which comprise the noble body of Clinton County, and attended to such concern, and in accordance with long-standing Clinton County tradition, we are proud to commemorate the 225th anniversary of the Town of Champlain. The town was formed on March 7, 1788. It is the most northeastern town in Clinton County. It lies upon Lake Champlain and the Great Chazy River, shares its northern border with Canada, and contains the villages of Champlain, Rouse's Point, and the hamlets of Coopersville and Paris Mills. The town is named in honor of the father of New France and the French explorer Samuel de Champlain, who first surveyed the area in which the Town of Champlain was located in 1609. And whereas, with good fortune and a vast and rich history, the Town of Champlain will continue to move forward as a safe and enjoyable community to call home in which to raise a family. And remaining fruitful over the decades of growth and change, the Town of Champlain continues its commitment to enhancing the quality of life of all of its citizens and ensuring a positive environment for residents and businesses, as well as supporting and advocating on behalf of its rich agricultural history. Be it resolved that the Clinton County Legislature pause in its deliberations and commemorate the 225th anniversary of the Town of Champlain and recognize its significance and the role it continues to play in the life for the community of Clinton County. And also be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution is suitably engrossed, can be transmitted to the leaders of the Town of Champlain. Larry will take care of that later. seconded by Butler, Gallagher, Dame, and Keenan. Congratulations to all of you, and hopefully you have a very nice day. Thank you.
Thank you, Harry. We have received several resolutions and or proclamations from our elected officials. They are all available to be viewed by the public and will be displayed in the boardroom of the town office. In addition to the one that Mr. McManus just referenced, we received words of congratulation from Janet Dupre, our assemblywoman. And I'll just read a little excerpt. She says, "The history of Champlain from its formation in 1788 and the prestige of sharing the name of Samuel de Champlain with the beauty of the lake, which connects your town with Vermont, are part of what makes Champlain unique. In addition, the town and its residents are daily ambassadors who welcome our Canadian neighbors and all across the United States-Canadian border. You are indeed a gateway to our country, state, and county, and you deserve all the accolades your town will receive on this 225th anniversary celebration." Janet expressed regrets that she was unable to join us today due to a family commitment, but we also received a resolution from the New York State Senate and Senator Betty Little. The next person I'd like to introduce is a very influential man in the North Country. This is Gary Douglas, President of the North Country Chamber of Commerce.
I'm actually the lesser known Gibson brother. My roots in Dannemora, I always used to go to the 15th of Redford, now I've gone to the 17th of Champlain. So, I thought the chamber was old at 101 years. 225, that's an awful lot of history, an awful lot of great history. And what's most remarkable of all is seeing the videotape that Cal Kastein took at that first town meeting. And seeing John Zerlo there asking for a permit. But seriously, this community has been the front line of so much history. Not just being on the front line, but being a participant as part of the front line, not just for 225 years, but really over 400 years. Champlain was on the front line of European exploration of the New World. You were on the front line of the conflict amongst empires for definition of North America. You were on the front line of American independence, then of the War of 1812. As was commemorated so aptly this morning, you were on the front line of the Underground Railroad and another generation questing for freedom. You were even on the front line of the Cold War. And today, really our thanks from the entire region for the remarkable role that many of you play, those of you who work for Homeland Security, those of you who work in the customs brokerage operations and in so many different ways here in Champlain, the front line of our remarkable and increasingly important economic relationship with Canada next door. You do a great job in that regard as part of the front line. Congratulations, and let's all commit to be back here in 25 years for the 250th.
Thank you, Gary. Our next speaker is the Honorable William Owens. I have known Bill for many years and can attest to his dedication, his caring, and his knowledge of the North Country. Mr. Owens is a native of Long Island who found himself at Plattsburgh Air Force Base and loved the area so much he decided to stay and has been with us for over 30 years. Before coming to Congress, Mr. Owens was a managing partner at Stafford Owens, Pill & Renee and Trombley Law Firm in Plattsburgh. Our congressman has represented the 21st District since 2009.
Champlain, or at least when I think about Champlain, I think about what it means as the gateway to upstate New York and to New York State, to our Canadian neighbors. Whenever I have conversations with my Canadian colleagues, I interact with many of the members of Parliament on a regular basis, and you would be amazed at the number of folks, whether they're from Western Canada or they're from PEI, know about the town of Champlain. They have heard of the tremendous welcome that their Canadian friends receive when they come down here, and I'm very grateful for that. Champlain, for me, represents much in the way of business opportunity before I came to Congress. It now represents for me the opportunity to explain to people how beneficial this part of the country is to the rest of the country as a gateway for economic growth and development in the area of trade. As Celine pointed out, she told a story about Brain Brief. I will tell one as well. About 2 years ago, I had the opportunity to be in the White House for St. Patrick's Day. I'm of Irish descent. And the Taoiseach, Prime Minister of Ireland, got up to give a speech, and he said that as a young man in Western Ireland, he had been taught how to give a speech. That was to stand up tall to be seen, speak loudly to be heard, and sit down to be appreciated. Thank you very much.
We've also received resolutions from Senator Schumer and Senator Gillibrand. As I mentioned before, all these resolutions and citations will be available in the town office for viewing. We also received a citation from Governor Cuomo, and I will read this one. It's really not this long, and this is the originals in the office. So. Whereas recognizing the value and importance of preserving the rich history and heritage of our great state and nation, the citizens of New York welcome the opportunity to respectfully acknowledge the 225th anniversary of the founding of the town of Champlain. And whereas situated in the northeastern corner of beautiful Clinton County in the Adirondack region of New York State, bordered by Grand Isle County, Vermont, and Lake Champlain to the east, the town of Chazy to the south, the town of Morris to the west, and the international border with St. Bernard-de-Lacotte, Quebec, Canada to the north, Champlain is named after Samuel de Champlain, the first European explorer to view the area in 1609. The town was first settled by Pliny Moore, a pioneer who received a land grant in return for his service in the New York militia. The town was officially incorporated on March 7, 1788, and Judge Moore later became a prominent politician in the New York Assembly. And whereas, historically, Champlain's shoreline on Lake Champlain and its role as an outpost on our nation's northern border made the area a critical location during the War of 1812. In more peaceful times, the many streams and rivers flowing to the lake perpetuated the building of sawmills, and the abundance of dense forest made milling one of the town's major occupations. Over the centuries, this quaint community grew and prospered. And whereas the true greatness of a community comes from the heart and soul of the people who live there, the residents of Champlain can be remarkably proud of the region's impressive cultural, educational, recreational, social, and historic offerings and attractions. And those with the good fortune to visit this gracious area know they too have discovered a very special and charming place. And whereas, a community within the metropolitan radius of the city of Plattsburgh, Champlain is home to distinguished and accomplished individuals. It is these extraordinary people who have defined this town over the last 2.25 centuries. And truly deserve to be commended for their steadfast commitment towards sustaining and honoring their past while contributing in meaningful ways that impact the present and shape the future. And now, therefore, I, Andrew M. Cuomo, Governor of the State of New York, do hereby cite the 225th anniversary of the town of Champlain and congratulate everyone who joins in celebration of this significant milestone. Signed by the governor. Sign that reads 1788-2013. We're all familiar with these type of inscriptions. Oftentimes you see them on graveyard stones. Usually one signifies birth and the other signifies the end. I am very fond of a little book I discovered called A Dash. I think of what happened from the time of the birth of the charter of our town in 1788 and where we are today. The dash is what is important. 225 75 years. The Datch is our history. Today we are very fortunate to have a young lady who has spent her life studying American history, specifically the history of our North Country. She is a graduate of our own State University of Plattsburgh with a BA in History, summa cum laude, followed by a PhD from the University of Michigan. Since 2008, she has been the Clinton County Historian. Not only is she the county historian, but she is also an associate professor at SUNY Empire State College and the coordinator of the Plattsburgh unit of Empire State College. I am pleased to introduce Dr. Anastasia Pratt, who will give us a history of the town of Champlain.
Johnson, Gregory, Dunning, Dewey, Bell,
Fox, Squires, Lajeunesse, Anderson, Hazen, Fitch, Root, and Graves. That's just a few, I promise. Many descendants of those families continue to live in this town and this region, giving us even more reason to celebrate this anniversary. Settled, as we've seen, in 1788, the town of Champlain was chartered by the state of New York on March 7, 1787, and declared in the laws of New York of 1789, all that part of the county of Clinton, itself newly formed, lying to the northward of the town of Plattsburgh, south of the boundaries of this state, west of the east bounds of the county of Clinton, and east of the county of Montgomery, shall be and hereby is erected into being a town by the name of Champlain. Included in this town were parts of Chazy, Altona, Moores, Ellenburg, Clinton, and Chateauguay, each of which was formed in later legislative acts. By 1790, only 2 years after settlement, 578 people lived here, and that number swelled quickly. By 1810, there were 1,210 residents of Champlain, and 10 years later, 1,618. In fact, for much of the 19th century, Champlain rivaled the village of Plattsburgh, now the city, for population, business, and industry. As a result, roads were constructed early on, with the first three being the road connecting the village north to Canada, an important highway still, a road connecting the village to the rapids, and a road connecting the Dewey's house and lands to the lake at the east. That last road, of course, played another important role in the life of the town, in that it witnessed the first movements of the British military into Clinton County during the lead-up to the Battle of Plattsburgh. We remember that event each year at a ceremony that begins the Battle of Plattsburgh Commemoration Week and is organized by David Patrick, who, as we heard before, is a descendant of Pliny Moore. Each family, church, political office, business, and service industry has a long history within this town. If we took the time to detail every one, we'd definitely be here all night, and probably into tomorrow. Instead, let us suffice to say that, in its 225 years, Champlain has witnessed a multitude of changes, all of which have left us the town as we know it. I'll take just a moment to point out one such journey, that of the schools. From the town's first school, built in 1797, through the Champlain Academy and various smaller schools, and the eventual centralization that created the Northeastern Central School District, Champlain has offered educational opportunities for its children. That is significant, and not just because I'm a teacher. Thinking about and providing for education signals a desire to produce a well-educated future generation, and helps to explain why this town has long been so successful. On a personal note, and since anniversaries like this remind us to share the stories that will eventually become our collective history, I'd like to say that, for me, NCCS has always been synonymous with musicals and Mama Yuma. Though I attended the Peru Central School District, I had the very great fortune to play in pit orchestras here, and to roam the halls and speak in auditoriums and classrooms as a delegate to various committees at the Mali Humet. Those events were pivotal in my life, helping to point me in a direction that made sense for me educationally and has continued to make me enormously happy personally. Much later, I was also able to work with some local students during the 400th anniversary of Champlain's arrival. Seventh graders at NCCS completed posters and tiles related to life in Clinton County during the 1600s and early 1700s. Their work is permanently visible on the Clinton County Government Center in the Clinton County History Through the Eyes of Its Children mosaic. I love that their work, the work of local citizens, more than 200 years after the creation of their town, now celebrates the longer history of the county as a whole, and will continue to celebrate that history in perpetuity in an artwork installed on the building. Although we certainly won't create a similar mosaic here today, I think that those of us gathered here are helping to tell the story of 225 years of the town of Champlain, helping to create the dash between the years. As we leave, I hope that we'll continue to recall that history, not just the very small portion I've shared here, but the longer one that includes our parents and grandparents, our friends and compatriots, our farms and businesses. And I very much hope that we'll share those histories with each other so that they too can become part of the larger historical record of the next 225 years. And with that, I'd like to again thank you for inviting me here to celebrate this event.
We are between sets here with the Gibson brothers, and I thought I would step out here and take a look at the town area where they keep the sand during the winter months. There's still some sand left over, obviously, from last year. You want to have a little bit left over. You certainly don't want to use it all up. Well, these are the cars that are parked behind the town garage, along with the several of the trucks and other pieces of equipment. And we'll take a look from the front here in a moment. When they first announced that they'd have the Gibsons, I was very fearful that there'd be such a huge crowd that they couldn't manage it, but it looks like it's a manageable crowd, a full house for sure. And these are people wandering around between sets, and there's a steady flow of traffic out by the road, and a lot of volunteers out there, and law enforcement helping out to keep traffic flowing. And without the number of volunteers who have done things, seemingly thankless things like directing traffic and other things, selling hot dogs or whatever, this could not have been happening. And you can't close without thanking that committee for what they have done. People who watch the town board meetings know that last fall I mentioned it a couple of times that the town 225th was coming up, and I hope the town would do something to commemorate it. And I mentioned it again in the spring. We did a little bit at the St. Mary's Bazaar with the timeline reenactors, but that was a washout because we had nothing but rain through that weekend, on Memorial Day weekend. And then Celine Paquette stepped up, and Jane West and Julie Castine stepped up and decided they were going to do something here. And the weather cooperated, and it just couldn't be a more ideal situation here. And there's not a more popular group in the North Country than the Gibson Brothers, and those who attended can understand why. They're not only talented musicians, they are entertaining. It's a fun time to sit here and enjoy themselves, enjoying the Gibson Brothers and the group. And for those of you who saw me recording the Gibson Brothers concert, that was just for them. So you won't be seeing that on Hometown Cable, either on our website or on the cable system, and we won't be making DVDs available for sale. It's strictly, I told them I'd record that for them for a souvenir. Of course, I will keep myself a copy, but record it for them so they can keep track of this, because someday, 25 years from now, 50 years from now, they might want to look back and remember some of the things they did, and having a video recording of that would enhance the experience for them. So this will probably wrap up our look here for Hometown Cable viewers of the Champlain Day, August 17th, 2013. You've been watching viewer-supported local television, Hometown Cable. If you enjoy our programming and would like to see this continue, we've been going nonstop all day. My wife and I, Judy and I, both are going nonstop. But we need your support. And if you can't afford to support us, then at least take time to thank the people who do step up to the plate and support our efforts. But there's a lot of people out there who can't afford to support us and just, for whatever reason, either just forget to do it or think it's not necessary. They don't step up and support our efforts, and we really need everybody to do it. Otherwise, the things you see on Hometown Cable will no longer be happening unless people step up and send in that contribution to keep local programming coming and to help us keep that website up. Where right now we've got almost 9,000 videos online, and that's growing on a steady basis. Thanks for watching. For those of you who do support, viewer-supported local television, Hometown Cable.